Give us a sense. You follow one specific case that doctors have actually used stem cells to help repair this injury in a heart situation. Describe that.
So this is a 4-year-old girl. She was born with a single ventricle or a single pumping chamber. Most of us have two pumping chambers, one that carries blood to the lungs mm-hmm. to get oxygenated, and one that carries it to the rest of the oxygenated blood to the rest of the body. She lacked the right ventricle, so her body wasn't getting appropriate levels of oxygen, which is a potentially lethal defect if you don't get it fixed by surgery.
Is this blue baby syndrome?
Yes.
A lot of people may have seen there was a movie called, I think, Something the Lord Made about that.
That's
is that
correct.
Alan Rickman?
Yes,
right.
Right.
Okay.
Yes. And so there's already a procedure that's been established over the last 40 years, actually, to repair this defect. But one of the parts of it includes a Gore-Tex vessel or a Gore-Tex tube.
Like gloves, Gore-Tex,
sort of
the same material.
Or, yeah, polyester material or chemical material.
Right.
And it has a tendency to clot. It usually has to put in oversized, so it's something that's designed for adults. Anyway, it's not a perfect fix for this problem. And it actually is a way to bypass the heart rather than to replace the missing pump.
So they've used
the
stem cells to...
So they've used stem cells. They've implanted stem cells in a bioabsorbable tube in this girl's chest to make that vessel actually be real tissue instead of a plastic or a Gore-Tex tissue. And the operation was done 6 months ago, or about last August. The tube has gone away and has been replaced with, or has left in its place, this formed blood vessel, which by all accounts so far is working just fine.
Grown from her own cells. And I assume that the doctors look at this and they think there must be just far-reaching potentials for other types of medical scenarios and organs. What are some of the specific ones they're looking at?
There's a lot of effort. There's a lot of different types of stem cells and different kinds of tissue that are being used, but they're looking at repairing heart muscle that damaged by a heart attack. They're looking at spinal cord injuries. They're looking at hair follicles. They're looking at a whole lot of different areas. The notion is that after we're born, we've lost that capacity to make these things that we make when we're in the womb, but advances in stem cell biology, advances in genetics, doctors think that there's a way to reactivate these forces that will eventually enable us to create some of these repairs.
And quickly, what are some of the potential dangers of this? I mean, I can imagine when you're sort of experimenting in this way, I mean, you're growing a new organ sort of not in the way we initially were. What could happen?
Well, I mean, in this particular case, one of the worries is that, you know, will this vessel clot? Will it, narrow or restrict? But also, you're putting these cells in your body in a place where, they're not accustomed to being, or the body's not accustomed. You could grow out of control, so you could get some cancer. There could be immune responses that could, very dangerous or potentially even lethal. There was a case a number of years ago treating a heart muscle where the repair seemed to work, but it led to arrhythmias or irregular heartbeats. So there's lots of unintended consequences or possibility for that doctors are wanting to look out for. So it's been a very fascinating but pretty gradual, slow process to sort of work out all of the biology so we can move forward safely.
You can only imagine that the people who could benefit from this are just looking at this case and just be so optimistic, and yet it will probably be a